Much of what is thought about homeschooling is wrong. The conventional wisdom about this rapidly growing dimension of education is too simple, too stereotyped, and too stale. For instance, the Homeschool Legal Defense Association, despite its energetic lawyers and many admirers, is not the leader of homeschooling in this country. There is no leader, and no reigning ideology. There are instead, over 1 million children whose families want them to learn at home for many reasons. Some homeschoolers love the new online teaching programs like K-12. Some think they are a corporate plot. Some parents are homeschooling because their kids were learning more quickly than their teachers could keep up with. Some are homeschooling because their kids were learning more slowly than their public school teachers had patience for. Some homeschool because their children were unhappy at school. Some homeschool because they could not meet their needs any other way. Public school educators often worry that the children of such people will not learn necessary social skills. Homeschooling parents have said their children learned how to work with other people just fine, particularly with the many children and adults they encountered when they visited the library, went to church, or offered help around the neighborhood. With their parents so often at their side, they were able to see what good manners and self-confidence looked like, rather than be forced to adopt the jungle code of the average high school corridor. In many families, one parent stays at home to supervise the homeschooling, or trade off with other homeschooling parents when they have to be away. Homeschooling involves a tremendous commitment from the parents. At least one parent must be willing to work closely with the child, plan lessons, and keep on top of requirements. The most common homeschool arrangement is for the mother to teach, while the father works out of the home. There are a variety of educational materials geared for homeschooling, published by dozens of suppliers. Some are correspondence courses, which grade students work, some are full curricula, single-topic workbooks, or drill materials in areas such as math or phonics. Many of the curriculum providers are identifiably Christian, including several major homeschool publishers such as Bob Jones University Press, Alpha Omega Publications, and Home Study International. A major non-religious provider of homeschool materials is the Calvert School in Baltimore. Figures vary as to how many homeschools use published curricula or correspondence courses, but the Department of Education estimates that it is from 25 to 50%. The rest use a curriculum the parents and/or the child have devised. Education writer John Holt, a champion of homeschooling, suggested that no particular area of study was essential. He advised parents to use real-life activities, such as work in a family business, writing letters, bookkeeping, observing nature, and talking with other people as meaningful academic lessons. Homeschools might fall anywhere on this spectrum, between the tightly planned study of a formal curriculum to Holt's free-form, experiential learning. But first, before homeschooling, all the parents interested in teaching their children at home need to find out what laws apply to their state and school district. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Please stop by our site for more homeschooling info. If you are interested in a Christian, self-paced, online homeschooling course with customizable curriculum, just follow the link in the description.